गुड मॉर्निंग वंदन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लुक इन टू इंट्यूशन बिहाइंड परसेप्ट्रॉन. लेट अस से एक्स आई बी ए पीस ऑफ एविडेंस फॉर मेंबरशिप इन क्लास वन. देन फ्यूचर एक्स आई विल बी गिवन विद पॉजिटिव वेट डब्ल्यू आई एंड द फीचर्स दैट प्रोवाइड एविडेंस अगेंस्ट क्लास वन वुड बी गिवन विद नेगेटिव वेट्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल लेट्स हैव ए लुक इन टू दिस. 2x1 plus 3x2 minus x3 plus 5 greater than 0. For example, this is my perceptron. If this is greater than 0, I'll try to say class 1. Otherwise, I'll say it like class 2. These two features are trying to provide evidence in favor of class 1. This feature is trying to provide evidence against class 1. Evidence against class 1 means, suppose if I try to increase this x3 value. Suppose if I try to increase this x3 value, what's going to happening here is this total value is decreasing, right? This total value is decreasing. If I try to increase this particular value, this total value is decreasing because minus sign is there, right? That's why I am calling it like evidence against class 1. Total value decreasing means that might become less than 0 after some increments of x3, right? Suppose if I try to increase this x1 feature, then what will happen is this value also will be increased. This value also will be increased and this total value also will be increased, right? Then we can say that it's trying to maintain above 0. That means this is in favor of class 1. Similarly, this is also in favor of class 1. This is against class 1. It is trying to have evidence against class 1. Evidence in favor of class 1. X1 and X2 features. Like that you can think. And this feature is more important as compared to this feature. Because this is given with more weightage, right? 3 into X2. This is just 2 into X1. This is given with more weightage as compared to feature 1. Very important features would be given weights with larger magnitudes than the others. Although it might sometimes be possible to arrive at satisfactory decision boundaries in this intuitive manner using our domain knowledge, it would be more useful to have an algorithm that would automatically find the best set of weights given a training set of data. What I am trying to convey here is, if I am having some intuitive knowledge, if I want to gain that intuitive knowledge, first I need to study something and I should try to understand with the help of my brain and I should try to analyze that one. Once I analyze that one with the help of my brain after a lot of effort, I can try to guess the weights W1, W2 up to WD with the help of my analysis, with my domain knowledge. But I required so much of effort for that, right? I need to do so much of effort, manual effort for that one. I need to gain abstract knowledge and after that I need to analyze that one. Which feature might be in favor of this one, class 1, or which feature might be against to class 1. That analysis, everything should be done by me, right? And including which feature might be more helpful for our class. That weightage also I should try to predict, right? I need to apply so much of human intelligence. I don't want to do that one. What's my plan is, I'll try to collect a reasonable amount of training data, that x bar comma constant label, class 1 or class 2 label, the training data, amount of training data, some limited amount of training data, some reasonable amount. I'll try to collect that one. After collecting that training data, I'll try to ask perceptron learning algorithm to learn all those weights W0, W1 up to WD with the help of the training samples and using some error function followed by gradient descent algorithm or some variant of that one. That's our plan. That's what I am expecting from perceptron learning algorithm. There is no manual effort there, right? There is no much of manual effort in this case. That algorithm will try to learn the weights with the help of training data. We should provide some reasonable amount of training data in order to learn properly. The other notations we are going to follow. Let P represents the set of training samples belongs to class 1. P he means passed, and any print set of training samples belongs to class 2. N means negative, P means positive, like that again thing. Then P union N represents the set of training samples. Let X bar equals to X naught X1 up to XD. This is D plus 1 cross 1, this is not D cross 1. We are adding extra X naught, where X naught equal to 1 for all training examples. This is just a notation. And W bar equals W naught W1 up to WD. This is D plus 1 cross 1, right? Along with this, we are trying to include double naught also into this. The D plus 1 cross 1. Now double transpose X bar equal to 0 is a linear addition boundary. If we try to expand this, we are going to get double naught to W1 X1 plus double 2 X2 up to double D X D. Because X naught equal to 1, right? Double naught X naught will be double naught only. Let us denote G of X bar equals to W transpose X bar. This is also called a discrimination function. Intuition for how to learn weights of linear addition boundary model. For example, if X bar belongs to P, but we got G of X bar less than 0 with the current weight vector W bar, then we need to update weights W bar in such a way that G of X bar will be increased after that update. See, here what is mentioned is X bar belongs to positive class. If that is belongs to positive class means that is class 1, actually we should satisfy g of x bar to be greater than 0. That should be greater than 0, right? For the positive class, double transpose x should be greater than 0 for positive class. But with the current weight vector, we got g of x bar less than 0. Then we need to modify the weights, and we need to update the weights in such a manner that this will be increased, so that after some time that might be above 0 after few iterations. That's what our plan. If ith feature xi has a positive value for that sample, then wi should be increased to increase g of x bar, where g of x bar equals to w1 x1 plus w2 x2 plus and so on wd xt plus w0. Let's try to have a look into this one. Actually, this is less than 0. We got less than 0. But we want this to be more than 0. Let's consider particular ith feature. Suppose xi is a positive value. If xi is a positive value, let's assume that some xi value. Let's consider xi equal to some 1, for example. This is positive value, right? Greater than 0. Then my wi xi will be wi, right? Wi xi will be, okay, just for convenience, let's go with 2. Wi xi will be 2 into wi. And my w transpose x bar equals to wi xi plus sigma j naught equals to I, j equal to 0 to d wj xj. I want to increase this, right? Actually, what I got is, I got this to be less than 0. I got this somehow less than 0, unfortunately, with the current weights. But actually, I need greater than 0. In order to increase this one, in this example, when xi is positive, this part will be 2wi. If I want to increase this value, I need to update this weight like this, right? For example, wa plus 0.1. Then what will happen? Wa plus 0.1 means I am going to have extra 0.2. This one plus 0.2, right? That means I am trying to increase this one with the help of this update. This is my past W transpose X. For the past W transpose X, this extra value I am adding. 0.1 into 2. 0.2 I am adding, right? Suppose instead of this, if I go with negative, it means that I am subtracting that, right? It's not good for me. I should increase this. I should not decrease this one, right? It means whenever this xi is positive in this particular example, then I should try to increase the constant weight wi in this particular case. However, if xi were negative for that particular sample, then wi should be decreased in order to increase g of x bar. Suppose in this case, this is negative instead of positive. For example, minus 2. Then this will be minus 2 wi. This will be minus 2 wi. In this case, our target is we need to increase this, right? And in our example, we need to increase this value further. In order to increase this value, if you try to update this in the same manner, plus 0.1, then what we are going to get is minus 2 into 0.1. This will be minus 0.2. This is decreasing, right? Instead of increasing, this is decreasing due to this negative sign. So in this case, we should not increase this weight. We should try to decrease this weight. We can go for example, just an example, minus 0.1. If you decrease this weight, then this will be plus 0.1, right? This will try to increase. That's what we need to do. However, if xi were negative for that sample, then wi should be decreased in order to increase this value. One simple way to update the weights in this situation is just add xi to old wi. Just add xi to old wi. A simple way. Yeah, what they are saying is, suppose x bar belongs to P, but unfortunately I got w transpose x bar less than 0 with the current weights. I should get greater than 0, but I got less than 0 with the current weights. Now I want to update this weight. I can try to update in this manner. In this example case, I can try to follow this update rule. If I do this one, then what will happen is w transpose plus x bar. This is updated, right? Let me call it like new. This is w transpose a new updated weights transpose into x bar. This will be equals to, this is old w transpose x bar plus x bar transpose x bar means norm x bar square. This is nothing but x naught square plus x1 square plus up to xd square. Norm x bar square means this is always positive quantity unless all those values are zeros. If x naught to xd all of them are zeros, that's not possible, right? All of them are zero, then this will be zero. This will never become negative. Most of the times or always this is positive. This is greater than 0, right? For all x bar not equal to 0, this is greater than 0. Now this will work out for us, right? We need to increase this value, increase our g of x bar in this case because we got less than 0. Now some positive value we are adding effectively, right? With the help of this update, this kind of update. W new equals to w old plus x bar. In these scenarios, if x bar is positive actually, but unfortunately you got less than 0, then we can do this operation. For example, x bar belongs to a negative class, it means class 2, but we got g of x bar greater than 0 with the current weight beta w bar. Then we need to update w bar in such a way that g of x bar will be decreased after that update. You can simply try to do quite opposite to earlier one, right? If ith feature of xi is positive value for that sample, then wi should be decreased to decrease this one. You can have similarity with earlier one, just quite opposite to that. Here you will try to do w bar new equals to w bar old minus x bar. Earlier we had done plus x bar, right? Now we should do minus x bar, because we need to decrease this g of x bar. And this is a perceptron learning algorithm. First, initialize the weights, because we don't know what are our expected weights, right? We are trying to ask that algorithm to learn the weights. For that, we will start with some initial random weights W0, W1, W2 up to WD. We can consider always to be 0 or to be some small random values, or if you are able to guess with your intuition, you can try to guess. Initial guess, good initial guess might be helpful for fast convergence. You can try to approach the solution much faster. Step 2. Choose the next sample x bar from the training set. Training set means that P union N. P means all positive class examples, N corresponds to all negative class examples. Positive class means omega 1 class examples, negative class means omega 2 class examples. After this, step 3, G of x bar equals W transpose x bar. Try to compute this one. W transpose x bar, perceptron value, try to compute this, or discriminant function value. And step 4 corresponds to, skip this step if the sample classified correctly. Classified correctly means, suppose this x bar belongs to P, and we got this g of x bar greater than 0, then that is classified correctly. If this x bar actually belongs to N, but we got and we got this one to be less than 0, then that's also correctly classified. If that is opposite, then that is misclassified. For example, consider this. Suppose that sample belongs to P, but we got W transpose X bar less than 0. Then we will try to update W bar as follows. W bar new equals to W bar old plus X bar. As you have seen that intuition, right? If that sample is from class 2 or that is negative class sample, but if we got W transpose X bar greater than 0, then we will try to update W bar as follows. W bar new equals to W bar old minus X bar. And after this step, we will try to update our old W bar with new W bar. W bar old equals to W bar new. And step 5. Repeat steps 2 to 4 with each of the training samples. This 2 to 4, try to repeat this for all the training samples, that P union N, all those samples. When finished, run through the entire training data set again. Stop and report perfect classification when all the samples are correctly classified during one complete pass of the entire training set. An additional stopping rule also needed, since this process would never terminate if the two classes were not linearly separable. A fixed imaginary number of iterations could be tried, or the algorithm could be terminated when the running average error rate ceases to decrease significantly. Need for feature normalization. If a particular feature usually has large values, the changes in its weight updates by this algorithm will also be large enough, right? That will also become large because we are trying to follow update as follows. W bar new equals W bar plus or minus X bar. Suppose X1 is very large value compared to X2, X3, X4 up to XD. Then the update for X1 also becoming huge, right? That's the problem we are going to get here. This is the opposite of what one would want or one would expect. If two features are about equally important, the one with large values should end up with small weight, and the one with small values should end up with large weight when they are equally important. To speed up convergence, we need to go for feature normalization. For example, you can go for Z-score feature normalization, which will try to make zero mean unity variance for all the features. We will try to apply Z-score feature normalization for all those D features. And some variant of perceptron learning algorithm. There are some changes in step 4. Remaining all steps are same. We will try to have some variation in this update. instead of having w bar plus x bar, we'll have plus alpha and x bar, where alpha is some positive quantity. Similarly, we'll have w bar minus alpha x bar in this case, where alpha is some positive quantity. And it will be good to consider x naught as average absolute feature value in the problem, so that changes in w naught will be about the same size as changes in other weights. It may speed up convergence. Changing the weight w naught translates the decision boundary, but leaves its orientation parallel to that of original position. For example, let's have a look into this. See w transpose x plus w naught equal to 0. See w transpose x plus w naught dash equal to 0. Instead of w naught, here b is the bias. These two are parallel to each other. The distance between these two parallel lines is r if that is hyperplane, when that is higher dimension. That is mod b minus b dash or mod w naught minus w naught dash divided by norm w bar is the distance between these two. They are just parallel, right? After this training process over, after using perceptron learning algorithm, after so many iterations, if they are linearly separable like this, these two classes are linearly separable, right? We may end up with one of these infinitely possible linear decision boundaries. Based on your initial weights, you might end up with this line as a decision boundary. This might be your decision boundary after training. This might be your training decision boundary. This might be your decision boundary. You'll have infinitely many such decision boundaries, possible decision boundaries, based on your initial weight vector. Thank you.